Good morning, everybody. Oh my God, do I ever shut up? Thank God people have the option of just not like even watching the stuff that I produce. Or whatever. It's not even producing, it's just I'm sitting here and blabbing on in front of a cheap old camera here. It's day 13, it's Z plus 13 for me. And my healing process continues. My swelling is going down and the skin is slowly healing. And last night I actually went out and with I actually put on my normal makeup and went out and I still wore this, but because my hair is black, it sort of blended in and it was nighttime and I don't think I looked too weird other than my own natural insecurities, but my own, sense of beauty or self-worth, which I commented early on about being part of homework that you do. What I wanted to reflect on is something I've hesitated to reflect on from the very beginning of Z plus one. With 12 days elapsed since then, I think I can discuss it with a little bit more clarity. When you undergo something like facial feminization, it is such a fundamental change in your appearance. And the thing is that people come to know you by your face, by your countenance. And I, for one, knew that I didn't recognize myself in the mirror because of my countenance. And that's why I needed facial feminization. In fact, I don't remember if I discussed the process that I went through, but over 2.5, 3 years of HRT, my facial features did change. They did become softer, and it actually got to the point where about 3 or 4 months before my surgery, I couldn't see the old me, the old masculine, expression of my face anymore. I couldn't see that aspect of me in the mirror, but I still saw male, and that's why I knew I needed to go through with this, because as long as I saw male, I was going to know that what I saw was not reflective of who I am. So on day one, I think it was a very dear friend of mine mentioned, and I'm sure she, it was heartfelt. I know it was heartfelt, and I know there was absolutely no harm intended. And I know that she's going to see this, and I'll just say, please, I never took any offense at it, and don't worry, it's all good. But I remember being told I miss the face that I used to see. And I think for just the briefest of instances, for just the briefest moment, I was heartbroken. And I can get back to that feeling of heartbrokenness very easily. It's something that was so powerful. It doesn't take much for me to re-experience the sadness I felt in that moment. Not sadness because I had gone ahead and done facial feminization, but the sadness that someone I care about so deeply, someone that I love so dearly, suffered a loss. And and that's something that I hope in time will heal for that person. I'm a happier person for my surgery. I won't be so arrogant as to say I'm not going to go around making any apologies for what I did. Maybe once I was like that, but in any case, if there were a way for me to have achieved my goals of feminization and still retain that sense of familiarity and comfort that people had with me, I would have done it. But there was no way I could do it. And I hope that as the healing process goes on, that people will come to remember and recognize the countenance that is reflective of who I am. And but for the sadness or pain or I don't know what the right feeling is that was encapsulated in that one briefest passing of statement. I wish there was a way to ease that sorrow of missing something you became familiar with. But I can't, and I would never go back and change my decision. And I guess that's it. Wow, I don't even know if I should post this one. Yeah, I may not. Okay.